Online. Today, we have a very special guest, our very own leader, Rock. He's going to lead us in a worship song called Confidence. Some of you may know it from Sunday Mornings with Rock. If not, the words are on the screen. Let's sing along and worship God together. Series. This week, we're going to be talking about the parable of the talents. But before we do that, does anyone know what this is? This is the garbage can from the Mighty Kids room. And like last week with my plant, you may be asking, Pastor Mariah, why are you holding a garbage can? Well, I'm going to tell you. So our story today is called the parable of the talents. And so you might think, Pastor Mariah, it doesn't take a lot of talent to empty a garbage can. And you're right. But you know what? It's as important as telling the Bible story or leading a game. Because if nobody emptied the garbage in the Mighty Kids room, it would pile up pretty quick. And if nobody cleaned the bathrooms or mopped the floors or swept the gym, it would get really gross really fast. And so I'm holding this garbage can today because in our story, Jesus is going to use the parable to explain how God gives us all different talents. He gives us all different abilities and different things that we are able to do. And so no talent or gift is more important than the other. Just like changing the garbage can isn't any less or more important than telling the Bible story. And so we're going to learn about the parable of the talents today. Before we tell our story, we're going to go over our Bible verse. So our Bible verse today is found in the book of 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. And it goes like this. God has given each of you a gift from his great variety of spiritual gifts. Use them well to serve one another. So this verse is saying God has given every single person special gifts and special talents, and that we are to use those gifts to help others. And so our Bible story today is about a master who had some people working for him, and he gave them each a different thing. And so we're going to find out today what happened with each of the workers. So I'm going to read the story out of my Bible, but as usual, you guys can follow along on the screen. Our Bible story today is found in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verses 14 to 30. And it goes like this. It's also like a man going off on an extended trip. He called his servants together and delegated responsibilities. To one, he gave $5,000, to another, $2,000, and to a third, $1,000, depending on their abilities. Then he left. Right off, the first servant went to work and doubled his master's investment. The second did the same. But the man with the single thousand dug a hole and carefully buried his master's money. After a long absence, the master of those three servants came back and settled up with them. The one given $5,000 showed him how he had doubled his investment. His master commended him. "Good work, you did your job well. From now on, be my partner." The servant with the $2,000 showed how he had also doubled his master's investment. His master commended him. "Good work, you did your job well. From now on, be my partner." The servant given $1,000 said, "Master, I know you have high standards and hate careless ways, that you demand the best and make no allowances for error. I was afraid that I might disappoint you, so I found a good hiding place and secured your money. Here it is, safe and sound, down to the last cent." The master was furious. It means he was really angry. He said, "That's a terrible way to live. It's criminal to live cautiously like that. If you knew I was after the best, why did you do less than the least? The least you could have done would have been to invest the sum with the bankers, where at least I would have gotten a little interest. Take the thousand and give it to the one who risked the most." So this story is telling us a lot about God. See, in this story, God is the master, and we are the workers. So the master gave the workers each a different thing. He gave one $5,000, he gave one $2,000, and he gave one $1,000. And two of the workers, they took their money right away and they doubled it. So they sold stuff, they bought stuff, and they made the master more money. They used the gift that he had given them and they made something more. But the last worker, he knew that the master was really strict and he was a little bit scared that the master was gonna yell at him if he lost his money or if he, you know, made a bad investment. And so he took the money and he dug a hole. And he put it in the hole. And so when the master came back, he said, "Master, look, I have all the money that you gave me." And the master said, "That's foolish. Look at the other people. They took their money and they made more money. But you just dug a hole and put yours in a hole." And so this story is explaining to us that God gives us all gifts. Maybe you're a great singer, maybe you're a great dancer, maybe you can draw really well, maybe you're really good at speaking in front of people, right? So God gives us all different gifts. And he's explaining that when God gives us a gift, we have to use it. We have to use it to bless other people, like in our Bible verse. And so our story today, God is telling us, "I'm going to give you gifts. I'm going to give you important things that you're talented at, and I need you to use them wisely," right? And so one of the gifts that God has given me is I'm a really good cook. I can make food taste really awesome. And so I love to use my gift to bless other people. I love to cook for other people, and it brings me a lot of joy. And so sometimes we think if we don't have certain gifts that we can't bless other people. Right? But that's not true. God gives us each a different gift. He gives us different talents, just like the master gave the workers all different amounts of money. And so sometimes you might think that your talent isn't important. You might think, "What I can do isn't that special." But God has given it to you, and he's given it to you for a reason. So think of it this way. Think of our life as a puzzle, as all of us together as a puzzle. And so I have a puzzle here. So this puzzle is complete, like this, right? But no piece is more important than the other. This corner piece isn't more important than this piece, and this piece isn't more important than this piece, because if you took away one of these pieces, the puzzle would be incomplete. It doesn't matter what piece you take, they're all important. And so God has given each of us talents like pieces of a puzzle. And when we use all our talents together, we make one big picture. But if you take away one piece, if you take away someone's gifts or someone's talents from the picture, then it's not complete. And so the world needs your talents. The world needs what God has given you. So I challenge you this week. I want you to think about the way that you can use what God has given you to bless others. How can you use the talents that God has given you to change the world? Because God has given us all different talents and abilities so that we can spread His love, so that we can give people hope, right? And so it's very important that we know what gifts God has given us and how we can use them. So this week, that's your challenge. I want you to think of how you can use your gifts to bless others. So when we pray, I usually like to close my eyes and bow my head. And it's for no special reason except that when we talk to God, He deserves our full attention. And when we close our eyes and bow our head, it helps us not be distracted by the things around us. When we have Mighty Kids in the Mighty Kids room, there's usually a lot going on. There's talking and moving. And so this way, we can give God our full attention. So let's close our eyes and bow our heads. I'm going to pray. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunity to be together online. I pray that this week that you would show us the gifts that you have given us, that you would help us have confidence in all the abilities and the talents that you have given us, that we would not be like the last worker and waste it. Pray that you would help us use our talents to bless others. Pray that you would help us to be kind and help us to be brave. In your name, amen. Thanks for joining us for Mighty Kids Online. We hope that you've been blessed by the service today. Remember that we are here every Sunday morning at 9:45. Also, don't forget about our Wacky Wednesday challenge. This week, it's a dance competition. So record yourself at least 30 seconds, busting a move to your favorite song, a dance move you've made up, and make sure to tag me, Pastor Mariah, in it. At the end of the week, there's going to be a prize for the best boy dancer and the best girl dancer. All the details can be found at the Mighty Kids page. Hope you guys have a great week. Thanks for joining us. Bye.